Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses, 17 races to bring you in the wake from the Breeders' Cup, including nearly half of them Saturday afternoon down at Gulfstream Park as they had Millions Preview Day. And we will kick it off with the Distaffers.
Racing in the Millions Distaff Preview to a beautiful beginning. Toward the inside, Puttyfoot the Gray is reaching up for the early lead. Quickly up to challenge is the favorite Devil's Cave, and the two favorites hook up early as they race into the first turn. Winning for Sarah comes away racing in third with Holiday Magic to her outside. Swinger's Party is three wide. Panichi Reigns Flutterby back to run third last, a length better than Don't Call Me Charlie, and trailing the field is Quinn Cat. They're trying to back down the early speed after the opening quarter went in 23-3. Puttyfoot on the inside re-engages. Devil's Cave was in the two-path. Swinger's Party has moved to closer third for Zayas within a length and a half of the lead and two lengths better than Holiday Magic, who takes it all in while racing fourth. Then it's a length back to Winning for Sarah with Flutterby between horses. Don't Call Me Charlie on the outside about eight lengths behind and five lengths to the trailer, Quinn Cat. Less than half a mile to go after a half mile and 47-2. Quick fractions being set here. On up on the outside, Zayas tips Swinger's Party three wide to make a move, and she makes it right now at Devil's Cave, who has the lead. Puttyfoot is back to third. Holiday Magic is asked to rally, and here's Longshot Don't Call Me Charlie chiming into it. She's third now and gaining into it with 5/16 to go. Tip to the outside is Flutterby, and Panichi scrubs on her for more. She's gaining as well with 3/16 to run now. Swinger's Party has the lead. They're by three quarters and 1/13-1, and Swinger's Party cuts the corner for home. Don't Call Me Charlie to the attack second. Flutterby is next, and from dead last, Quinn Cat begins to roll. There's an eighth of a mile to go in the Millions Distaff Preview, and Zayas trying to get one more furlong out of Swinger's Party, but here comes Longshot Flutterby down the center of the racetrack. Flutterby trying to catch Swinger's Party, who fights back, and Swinger's Party will win it. Flutterby with a great effort to be second in front of fellow Longshot Don't Call Me Charlie. She's in a photo for third with Quinn Cat down the outside, and they covered the course in 1:40-2.
Swinger's Party, Edgar Zayas in the saddle, third choice in the wagering, the offspring of Medaglia d'Oro, trained by Marty Wilson, scores by 3/4 length, returning $10.40. Couple long shots filling out the trifecta. Up first, Flutterby at nearly 17-1, followed by Don't Call Me Charlie, second longest shot on the board at nearly 32-1. They key at $1,240 trifecta. Devil's Cave, 7-5 favorite, finishes fifth. Up next, over to the turf for the Millions Turf Preview.
Racing in the Millions Turf Preview. It was a good start for Bad Debt from the outside. Toward the inside, Breitling Flyer moves to challenge, and from between horses, She's Spooky is away in the top flight. So too the Gray Triple Cross as they run out of the chute and link up with the main course. The leader is Breitling Flyer by a length and a half. She's Spooky is there second, and Triple Cross is taken in hand by Taylor Rice to race third, a length and a half in front of Bad Debt. Then it's Trier to his inside. The team at the back are the Philly E.B. Rider, and at the back, Poco Man. Racing into the first turn, and Breitling Flyer is loose up top by the opening quarter in 23-3. Breitling Flyer and Leandro Gonsalves have opened up a six-length lead. She's Spooky is racing in second from the inside. Triple Cross is now third. Bad Debt on a long hold by Paco Lopez, racing fourth with about six lengths to gain. Trier to the inside. Now Zayas is tipping E.B. Rider to the outside to force the hand of the favorite, and the trailer is Poco Man as they run down the backstretch. Breitling Flyer trying to catch a breather at the half mile, went through the half mile in 47-3, and Zayas got exactly what he wanted from the favorite Bad Debt as Lopez had to move him to the three path and quicken up as She's Spooky is now racing second. Trier toward the inside is racing in fourth from E.B. Rider, who's racing fifth. Triple Cross is shuffled to sixth, and the trailer here is Poco Man. They run around the far turn after three quarters in 1:11-3. They arrive at the top of the stretch. Bad Debt looms a threat on the outside. He's up to challenge for the lead. She's Spooky between them. Breitling Flyer tries to cut the corner and go on, and that's exactly what he's doing. Breitling Flyer is in front. Bad Debt is asked the question by Lopez on the outside, and Trier splits horses. Still nothing decided here with an eighth of a mile to go. Bad Debt digging in, but Trier's coming on. Here comes Trier at Bad Debt. Bad Debt digging in. Bad Debt is holding. The classy Bad Debt wins at a half a length from Trier second. Third, Breitling Flyer. It's close for fourth in 1:41-4.
Odds on, ladies and gentlemen, at 3-4 for Paco Lopez and Michael Trambetta. Bad Debt wins by half a length, returning the popular $3.20. Trier finishes second. Breitling Flyer finishes third. Staying on the turf, time for the 2-year-old juvenile fillies.
Racing in the juvenile filly turf. Some crowding in the center gates. That's quite all right with Hangover Saturday. She breaks cleanly from an inside post and looks for the lead. In between horses, Catflight Cowgirl with Gorgeous Dream on the outside. Discreet Romance comes away racing in fourth, a length better than Like a Queen. She's favored and relaxing nicely for Edgard Zayas. To her inside is Miss Margaret. On the inside rail, it's Wildcat Magic. And here comes Miss Kitty as last of all as they bend into the clubhouse turn. Hangover Saturday and Abdi El Hayen have secured an easy lead. They lead by almost two lengths from Gorgeous Dream, who races in second. Catfight Cowgirl and Ramsey Zimmerman back off to be third now. They're about 3.5 off the speed. Discreet Romance is on her outside, a length better than Like a Queen. That's the favorite. She's still about 5 or 6 off the top. Miss Margaret improves toward her inside. Here comes Miss Kitty is second last, and now the trailer is Wildcat Magic. Opening quarter, 25 seconds flat. They approach the half-mile pole, and Hangover Saturdays by a half-mile and 51-1. Huge advantage tactically to the leader, and the leader is still Hangover Saturday. Gorgeous Dream is second. Catfight Cowgirl is third. Here's Like a Queen. She's forced about 3 or 4 wide at the far turn run, but she starts to improve now as now the pace quickens. With the lead, it's Hangover Saturday moving up on her outside. Gorgeous Dream to take her on second. Catfight Cowgirl is now third. Like a Queen will have to do much better than that, and they're at the top of the stretch. Perfectly rationed on the front end. The leader is Hangover Saturday. Catfight Cowgirl tips off the fence to rally for Ramsey Zimmerman, and Gorgeous Dream is next. Miss Margaret rides the inside with an 1/8 mile to go. Hangover Saturday still has something in reserve and leads it by 2.5. Catfight Cowgirl on the outside. Miss Margaret toward the inside. Gate to wire win for Hangover Saturday. Miss Margaret gets second in front of Catfight Cowgirl third, then Gorgeous Dream fourth in 139-1.
Hangover Saturday. Abdi El Hayen scores the front end victory, making every call, going from an inside post position, short run into the first turn. This offspring of Pomeroy had the pedal on the metal, goes to the front, had a comfortable lead on the backstretch, wins by 2.25 lengths, the second choice in the wagering for David Fox. Hangover Saturday returns $7.40. Miss Margaret finishes second, and third choice in the wagering, Catfight Cowgirl, finishes third. The even money favorite, Like a Queen, beats one horse in the juvenile filly turf. Sticking with the juveniles, though, onto the dirt for the sprint.
And they're off in the juvenile sprint. It was a slow beginning for Dukin with Dale. Lakota Warrior flew out of the gate and opens up a 2-length lead already from Sing Praises, who will be taken in hand by Zimmerman to race in second. Mr. Jordan, the favorite's a bit keen, racing fourth with Morgan's Harbor on the outside third. Widest of All is Hear That Tune, then Fierce Tide. 225A is third last. Second last after a subpar beginning is Dukin with Dale, and Valico is last as they move through the opening quarter in 22-4. It's Lakota Warrior in front 3/4 of a length from Sing Praises in the two-path second. The gray, Mr. Jordan, is down inside racing a joint third with Morgan's Harbor and Hear That Tune. Hear That Tune is 4 wide on the outside. Then it's Fierce Tide, 4 in front of 225A. Toward the outside, Dukin with Dale is second last, and Valico is last, and there's 5/16 to go. Lakota Warrior is still in front and still sharp. Goes to the quarter pole, 3/4 in front. Mr. Jordan crying for room. No place to go yet. Paco will be patient and glad to the outside here as they're at the top of the stretch. Mr. Jordan shown open racetrack with Sing Praises hitting the front. Lakota Warrior trying to come back at him, and Morgan's Harbor is fourth with 1/8 mile to go. Look at this. Mr. Jordan taken in hand and wrapped up while pulling clear. Wow. This son of Cantharos is the real deal. Mr. Jordan easily by 3 lengths. Morgan's Harbor second. Sing Praises third. 225A up fourth in front of Lakota Warrior in 118-1.
Mr. Jordan, Paco Lopez in the saddle, riding for Eddie Pleaser Jr. This is an offspring of Cantharos, was odds on at 4-5. It makes it look easy, winning by 3 full lengths, returning $3.80. Morgan's Harbor finishes second. Sing Praises finishes third in the juvenile sprint. Up next, the Millions Classic Preview.
And they're off in the Millions Classic Preview. Excellent beginning for Wildcat Red, and he heads off to try to take the early lead, but Jose Caraballo and I'm Stepping It Up have similar ideas, so each Wildcat Red will be taken in hand by Edgar Prado, and I'll Stepping It Up takes the lead. Wildcat Red now into the two-path while racing in second from Chivarelli, who's three wide through the initial stages, while third. In between horses, that's Senor Kiskiano with Mega Move down to the inside. Then it's into East Hall. He's racing second last, and he's five lengths better than Undeniable Temper, who's last of all as they move into the backstretch run. They went through the opening quarter in 23-2, and at 30-1, I'm Stepping It Up leads the way by a length and a quarter. Favorite Wildcat Red is now racing second from Chivarelli, who's now third while three wide. Senor Kiskiano is next. Then it's a length back to Mega Move, who's on the inside. They're followed by Indiana Derby winner East Hall within five lengths of the lead and five lengths more to Undeniable Temper. They pass the half-mile pole after a half-mile in 47-1, and they kick to the far turn. It's still I'm Stepping It Up, who leads it now by a length and a half. Wildcat Red chirped along by Prado to get after the leader in second. Lopez goes to work on Chivarelli, who's now third in front of Senor Kiskiano, fourth. Now asked to quicken up is Luis Saez aboard East Hall. He's racing fifth and needing to do better as Wildcat Red just hit the front. Three quarters, 1:12-2, and Wildcat Red has the lead. Chivarelli comes under pressure to try to gain second. East Hall now swung into action and begins to find his best stride with 3/16 to go. East Hall moving up on the outside to try to get to Wildcat Red, who digs deep and tries to find more. Chivarelli is now third. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Here's the matchup. East Hall on the outside, Wildcat Red on the inside. Wildcat Red trying to stave off the rally, but East Hall's got him now, and East Hall's moving away. It's Luis Saez and East Hall for Bill Kaplan on the wire by two. Close for second. Give it to Wildcat Red gamely over Chivarelli. Then I'm Stepping It Up in 146-4.
Boy, the bettors got it right, folks. They've only bet three horses in this race of note in the field of seven, and they complete the trifecta, not in a perfect order, but the good guys score with East Hall, who was the third choice in the wagering at 2-1. A patient ride by Luis Saez for Bill Kaplan scores by a comfortable two lengths, taking over in the lane, returning $6.80. The 6-5 favorite, Wildcat Red, finishes second. And second choice in the wagering, Schiavarelli, the 2-1 second choice, finishes third in the Millions Classic Preview. Time to go back to the two-year-olds on the turf in the juvenile turf.
And they're off in the juvenile turf. It was a level beginning. From the outside, Less Than Perfect wins the start and goes looking for the lead. Down toward the inside, Platinum Prince is showing speed. And moving up the challenge is Chocolate Wildcat. Chocolate Wildcat and Platinum Prince go quickly early. They've opened up three lengths now on Black Martino, who moves up to be third. Less Than Perfect is now fourth, two lengths better than I'm Venezuelan, who rides the hedge for Richard Aramia, a length and a half in front of Fire Spike. Then it's another length and a half back to the outside. Jaden's Best on Saintly tucks in off him. 2.5 clear of Hubba Shake, who's better than 12 behind this fast early pace. It's a stretch of three to Value Tempo, and Bold Animo is last of the 11 after the opening quarter went in 23-1. Down the backstretch they go, and it's Platinum Prince in front three parts of a length. Chocolate Wildcat is there second. Black Martino is third, pocketed up. A neck better than Less Than Perfect, who's now racing fourth for Taylor Rice, two in front of I'm Venezuelan. Tipped off the fence to rally now is Fire Strike, a length better than Unsaintly. Then it's Bold Animo, who's made a couple spots. Hubba Shake is still cautiously ridden. He's third last. Second last is Jaden's Best, and last of all is the Gray Value Tempo after a half mile went in 47-1. Around the far turn with less than three furlongs to go, Platinum Prince still in front. Chocolate Wildcat moves to him again second. Fire Spike is four wide. Less Than Perfect worked off the fence and now races third. Then Black Martino cutting the corner is Unsaintly with the Dream Run through in there, and they're inside the final 3/16. Platinum Prince on the inside, down the outside here's Fire Spike, and Fire Spike just took over and bids this field a good afternoon. It's Fire Spike and Edgar Prado to give Mike Maker another one. He's impressive in victory by three lengths. I'm Venezuelan second from Less Than Perfect in third. It's a close photo for fourth between Unsaintly and Black Martino in 136 flat.
Fire Spike, the 8-5 favorite, the offspring of Flower Alley, going out for Mike Maker and Edgar Prado, makes it look easy with a comfortable 3.5 length score, returning $5.20. I'm Venezuelan finishes second. Less Than Perfect finishes third in the juvenile turf. And sticking with the juveniles, time for the fillies to sprint.
And runners away in the juvenile filly sprint. From the outside, Jamie's Dancer wins the break and goes looking for the lead. Down toward the inside, Coco's Wildcat moves to challenge. And Holywell from between horses, Saving Time, comes away in the top flight. It's a four-way go early. Moment of Delight comes away racing in fifth with Awesome Ice next. Then down toward the inside, Some Roar, 2.5 lengths better than Joni Gale, who's a length and 3/4 in front of Like a Charm. Then it's a stretch of 5 lengths to Leo DeFontaine and Leap Your Luck on her outside after the opening quarter went in 22-3. Less than half a mile to go, and they're chasing the speed of Coco's Wildcat. Saving Time is second. Holywell is third. Some Roar is next on the inside with Moment of Delight on the outside. Then it's a length back to Jamie's Dancers, who's ridden now from 3 furlongs from the wire. Another 5 in front of Awesome Ice. Then Like a Charm, Leap Your Luck begins to get underway around Joni Gale, and Leo DeFontaine is still last, and Saving Time just took the lead. Saving Time is 1/4 mile from the money under Jonathan Gonzalez, confidently handled and 2 on top. That's all for Holywell and Coco's Wildcat. Moment of Delight tries to track her down, and from the backfield, Awesome Ice and Leap Your Luck is finishing best of all. Here's Leap Your Luck with 1/8 mile to go, trying to track down Saving Time. Whip is out on Saving Time, but Leap Your Luck going 2-1 and right on by. Leap Your Luck and Jesus Rios for the Jaxer Better Farm to win the Juvenile Philly Sprint by 2. Saving Time was second in front of Moment of Delight third, then Holywell and Joni Gale in 1:19-1.
Leap Your Luck. Breaking from an outside post position, well back early, well in front late, winning by 2.25 lengths under for Stanley Gold and Jose Rios, returning $17.20 for the upset. Saving Time finishes second, and the betting favorite, Moment of Delight, 5-2, finishes third. I want to take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action over the weekend from Woodbine.
The Capital OTB Handicapping Challenge Series is back. That's right. The 2014 Capital OTB Handicapping Challenge Series is back, and it's your chance to win thousands in cash and prizes and a seat at the 2015 Handicapping Championship in Las Vegas. This month's contest is the Capital Cup on December 6th. So sign up today online at CapitalOTB.com or stop in at the Clubhouse Racebook.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
The future of online betting is here, and only at the all-new CapitalOTBBet.com. With a newly designed and engineered internet wagering platform, enhanced video streaming, additional funding options, and 3 new individual wagering opportunities, CapitalOTBBet.com delivers a state-of-the-art wagering experience found nowhere else in horse racing. Combine that with our all-new mobile website, you have 2 of the most powerful, innovative, and advanced wagering platforms available today. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
Heading up to Woodbine for weekend stakes action, 2 of them on Saturday. Up first, Frost the King Stakes.
They're at the post. They're off in the Frost King Stakes. Where's the Widget? Had a quick beginning from that outside stall. And now Executive One in that orange cap comes on. Closer to the rail as they prepare to come onto the main track. Sent up in between horses is Saphira in the pink. Back and forth is Super Colorosa. Then we have Where's the Widget? At the rail is Kingsport. Second to last, Good Old Hockey Game. And Know It All trails this field as they run up the backstretch. 23 flat for the opening quarter mile in the Frost King. And on the inside, it is Executive One. Executive One leads it by 3/4 of a length. The Clarendon winner, Saphira, is second. Where's the Widget at long odds? Gains ground rapidly with 3 furlongs to go. Phil's Cocktail is in fourth, just a length and a half off the lead. Then we have Super Colorosa, Kingsport. A break of 3.5 lengths being hard ridden now is Good Old Hockey Game. To that one's outside is Know It All. And sweeping up on the outside is Phil's Cocktail to come on and take the lead. And the Simcoe winner, Phil's Cocktail, leads them into the stretch with a 2.5 length lead. Super Colorosa in an all-out drive. Good Old Hockey Game on the far outside. But it is Phil's Cocktail. Phil's cocktail to win the Frost King. To a closing good old hockey game, Super Colorosa was third and Kingsport was fourth.
Phil's Cocktail scores the victory, returning $15.50 for the upset of the 3-4 favorite, ladies and gentlemen. Good old hockey game. Not good enough on the racetrack. Finishes second at odds on. Super Colorosa finishes third in the Frost King. And now time for the Phillies on Saturday afternoon in the Jammed Lovely.
They're off in the Jammed Lovely. Between horses Sky, Land, or Girl, down toward the rail is Fun of the Desert, who comes on. Executive Allure's to the far outside. Executive Allure emerges from that pack with the early lead. Fun of the Desert comes on second as they come onto the main track. Skylander Girl in that pink cap takes over second now. Between horses, Unspurned comes on third. Fun of the Desert relegated to fourth as they run up the backstretch. 2.5 lengths to on Rainbow Bridge to that one's inside. Bambara Bold, 22-3 for the opening quarter. Less than a half mile to go in the Jammed Lovely. And Executive Allure leads it by just over a length to Unspurned. Skylander Girl third. Fun in the Desert patiently handled at the rail in fourth position. To the outside is on Rainbow Bridge in that white cap. Then Bambara Bold. They ran a half in 45. And they come to the quarter pole. And it's Executive Allure with a precarious lead. Here comes Unspurned. Here comes Skylander Girl. Here comes on Rainbow Bridge. And they're into the stretch. Executive Allure is finding more at the rail. Skylander Girl in an all-out drive. Far outside for on Rainbow Bridge. Executive Allure, she is running her heart out. And she's coming to the line to win the Jammed Lovely by open lengths. Unspurned was second. Skylander Girl third. And on Rainbow Bridge was fourth.
Another upset in here. Executive Allure. Cowboy Jesse Campbell puts the offspring of Bold Executive on the front. Never looks back. Wins by a convincing 3.5 lengths, returning $12.20. Unspurned, second choice in the wagering at 2-1 with Justin Stein, finishes second. Skylander Girl finishes third. The 9-5 favorite in Saturday afternoon's Jammed Lovely, Fun in the Desert, beats one horse while finishing fifth. Sunday afternoon at Woodbine, the 108th running of the autumn.
They're off in the Autumn Stakes. And Midnight Aria immediately to the lead. Are You Kidding Me to the outside, second. Alphabetters third. Luke Sally settles into stride in fourth. Irie is to the outside of Luke Sally, and War Correspondent is at the back of the pack as they run by the 7/8 pole. And it's Midnight Aria dictating the early pace. Are You Kidding Me? A length and a half back in second. Alphabetter to the inside, third. Irie is in the fourth position. Luke Sally is fifth and four lengths off the lead. War Correspondent tugging hard on Patrick Husbands at the back of the pack as they enter the back stretch. And it's Midnight Aria being coddled on a lead of a half a length. Are You Kidding Me? Is second. Alphabetter saved ground through that initial turn. Then Irie and Luke Sally. War Correspondent is at the neck of Luke Sally. 49 flat for the opening half mile. Midnight Aria shadowed by Are You Kidding Me? Alphabetter in the light blue to the inside. Then Irie. War Correspondent asks for more run. Luke Sally's to the inside of War Correspondent as they run through the turn. Midnight Aria by a neck. On the outside, Are You Kidding Me? The favorite, Luke Sally's, been shuffled to a trailing position, and they're at the top of the stretch. Midnight Aria, Are You Kidding Me? Here comes War Correspondent, and Luke Sally is wheeled to the far outside and is trying to close now for Luis Contreras, the Durham Cup winner. Luke Sally is surging at War Correspondent and Midnight Aria, 70 yards to the wire. Luke Sally! Luke Sally from last to first to win the Autumn Stakes. The War Correspondent with Midnight Aria third.
And if you've been watching racing at Woodbine this past week, it looked like very, very late autumn with jockeys wearing ski masks, but that's besides the point. Luke Sally, the 6-5 favorite with Luis Contreras in the saddle, back early, scores by a neck, returning the popular $4.40. Even farther back early in the race, War Correspondent finishes second. Midnight Aria, longest shot on the board, finishes third in Sunday's Autumn Stakes. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Remington Park, Churchill Downs, and Golden Gate.
I don't know. You hang around here. What do you think?
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
I'm Seth Merrill. Join me weekdays at 10 for Racing Across America. We'll look at important races from around the country, get insight from top handicappers and analysts, and preview the upcoming week in racing. That's Racing Across America, weekdays at 10, right here on the OTB TV network.
Out to Oklahoma, ladies and gentlemen, on Friday evening, the Clever Trevor Stakes.
They're off in the Clever Trevor Stakes. Into view, Lord Tyrion battling for the front with Baird. Superstroke is right there as well. Outside, the lone filly goes with the speed, and that's Strawberry Baby. She's on the front now by a full length as they go to the back stretch. Baird is second, tugging rider Santana towards Strawberry Baby, only a half length back, Superstroke third at the rail. And Lord Tyrion fourth by a head over Sky Full of Stars. Gap of about a length into Shotgun Cowboy and the bright gray Runaway Bling. Dream It Do It inside, only five off the lead, getting a rail trip with a half mile to go. Opening quarter went at 23 seconds and change. And Superstroke is just inside a Bear, nose to nose. Three wide going to the turn now. That's Strawberry Baby. After that, it is Sky Full of Stars, fourth, taking that over from Lord Tyrion. Shotgun Cowboy let free now, sixth and gaining ground. Will have to go wide midway through the turn. Baird, nose-to-nose with Strawberry Baby as they reach the quarter pole. The half mile went at 45 and 4/5 seconds, top of the stretch in the Clever Trevor Stakes, and Baird has the lead by a head. Strawberry Baby is second. Here comes Shotgun Cowboy rolling right down the middle of the stretch. He's second and gaining on Baird. Inside the furlong pole, Baird all out, up by neck. Shotgun Cowboy presses forward. Shotgun Cowboy takes the lead late. Baird tries to answer back. It's Shotgun Cowboy in the Clever Trevor Stakes. Baird was second. Third goes to Dream It Do It outside of a photo of three runners for fourth.
Shotgun Cowboy, the slight second choice in the wagering Friday evening at even money under Luis Quinones, scores the one-length victory, returning $4 even. Baird, the odds-on 4-5 favorite with Ricardo Santana in for the ride, finishes second. And at nearly 50-1, Dream It, Do It finishes third in Friday evening's Clever Trevor. Saturday afternoon, time for three-year-olds and up on the turf over at Churchill Downs in the River City.
They're all in line. They're racing in the River City. And it is our great adventure. Set the sail into the outside. There goes Silver Max. And Silver Max up to take the lead now. As expected, he will make the pace. Silver Max now scampers away to a two-length lead over Set the Sail. Our great adventure. And then to the outside, Green Grass of Wyoming. Under Control is on the far outside. Villandry's in behind them. And then comes Guy's Reward. Gentleman's Kitten is next after a 24 1/4. He's seven lengths off the lead. After that comes Hamp, followed by Aldous Snow to the outside. And well back early is Dramedy. Now they race on the first turn where the leader is Silver Max. Robbie Alvarado and Silver Max onto the back stretch in front, and the lead a length and a half to Set the Sail. And then it's a 2.5-length gap back to Green Grass of Wyoming, Villandry, and Our Great Adventure on the inside. In behind them, Under Control, Guy's Reward is next, and they're followed by Gentleman's Kitten, who's got 6 lengths to make up after a 47.3-half mile. Hamp has 10 lengths to gain at this stage, and then Al de Snow and Dromedy. And now the field races for the far turn, and Silver Max continues to lead the way. Silver Max, 3/4 of a length, set the sail. Second to the outside, Villandry is in third. And then it's Green Grass of Wyoming in fourth. Guy's Reward behind them. Gentleman's Kitten is going up 4 wide. And they're coming to the top of the stretch, and Silver Max trying to take them the distance. Turns for home in front by 1.5 lengths. Set the sail on the outside, comes after him. And here comes Villandry down the center. Guy's Reward up the rail. And now it is Villandry. Villandry has taken the lead and is pulling away as they come inside the final 16th. Hamp has moved up into second, but it's going to be Villandry in the River City. Hamp was second and then came Under Control, followed by Guy's Reward and Dromedy.
Villandry, Charlie DePresti sends out this offspring and Mr. Greeley for a 2.75 length victory with Julian Leperoux in the saddle. Second choice in the wager returns $10.60. Hamp at nearly 38-1 finishes second, Under Control third. Silver Max, odds on at 9-10, finishes sixth in Saturday's River City Handicap. Head up to Northern California, 2-year-olds at Golden Gate in the Golden Nugget Stakes.
Stand by for a start. Racing. Son of a Royal is away very fast out wide from Rainsford, who's matching and heading him now. Now there's Cartoonist coming through and Bluegrass Sight getting along the inside, followed fifth by Stalk the Wildcat and Lucky 49er as last of all. A little here between Rainsford and Cartoonist. Cartoonist has taken a little while to work his way to the front, but now he establishes a lead of almost a length. Past the half mile, it's Cartoonist from Rainsford, and Bluegrass Sight on the inside is third. A length to Stalk the Wildcat, followed a bit wider by Son of a Royal, who's dropped back next to last, and Lucky 49er is 3 lengths off at the tail. Cartoonist leading halfway around the turn from Rainsford and Bluegrass Sight, followed by Stalk the Wildcat, who's beginning to improve now. He's in the clear, being hooked to the outside by Gonzalez. Into the stretch, and Cartoonist under the whip leads, but here comes Stalk the Wildcat. Rainsford back to third on the outside of Bluegrass Sight. It's Stalk the Wildcat rolling past Cartoonist at the 16th pole. Rainsford is next, and Bluegrass Sight battling on, but the lead keeps increasing for Stalk the Wildcat. Nice looking stretch run from this son of Minister's Wildcat. He spaced them in the Golden Nugget. Won by 6 lengths from Cartoonist, and it's a photo third to split Rainsford and Bluegrass Sight. They were clear of Lucky 49er and Son of a Royal.
Stalk the Wildcat made it look easy for Jerry Hollendorfer. The offspring of Minister's Wildcat was the even money favorite. Wins by a handful, returning $4 even. Cartoonist finishes second as second choice in the wagering. Rainsford finishes third in Saturday's Golden Nugget. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, yes, racing at Del Mar after Election Day and the Big A.
Wagering at CapitalOTBBet.com is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1. Capital Bet TV, the fastest and easiest online wagering experience where you can monitor 5 different tracks simultaneously. 2. Capital Bet Express, its straightforward program layout and interactive handicapping information lets you build your wager quickly and efficiently. And 3. Capital Bet Pro, designed especially for the professional horse player. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
I'm Jeff Carl. Join me Saturdays and Sundays at 9 for the Handicappers Report. We'll handicap the top tracks across the country and help you prepare for the weekend in racing. That's the Handicappers Report. Weekends at 9, only here on the OTB TV network.
Missed one of our TV shows? No worries. Now you can catch all your favorite programs online. Simply log on to CapitalOTB.com and click on the YouTube link at the bottom of the homepage. And look for our new podcast coming soon. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
The Capital OTB Handicapping Challenge Series is back. That's right. The 2014 Capital OTB Handicapping Challenge Series is back, and it's your chance to win thousands in cash and prizes and a seat at the 2015 Handicapping Championship in Las Vegas. This month's contest is the Capital Cup,
on December 6th. So sign up today online at CapitalOTB.com or stop in at the Clubhouse Racebook.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, this week's edition of Horses and Courses. Time to turn our attention to Southern California, ladies and gentlemen. On Friday afternoon, they kicked off the inaugural Bing Crosby meet at Del Mar. This year is going to be a little light on the racing calendar. Looks like 15 racing days. Next year, they look to have, I think, at least 4 full weeks of racing. But on Friday afternoon, showing that management did the right thing, named after Bing Crosby's widow, the Catherine Crosby.
And away they go. Kathleen Rose broke away smartly, sets off for the lead. Gender Agenda came out well, as did Wishing Gate. And now there goes Miss Eleni up to join the leaders. Oscar Party's on the outside with Duchessa alongside of her. Burning Archer's racing back seventh. Then it's the Grey bound for Eden. Be Brave along the inside, giving them 8 length start. Racing in behind that comes Queen of the Sand. They followed by Kitten's Point and Floral Romance. 3/4 of a mile to go now, and Kathleen Rose sets the pace. Right up alongside comes Miss Eleni. Those two set a good pace up front too. Wishing Gate and the Gold tucked in along the inside. Gender Agenda's alongside of her. They followed by Oscar Party. Duchessa in the red colors, 5 off the leaders. A length and a half back to Burning Arch, and then comes Bound for Eden. Be Brave down at the rail is giving them 8 length start. Up alongside Queen of the Sand. They're getting closer now. Then Kitten's Point and Floral Romance. They head past the 3/8 pole, and Kathleen Rose is still the leader. Miss Eleni's been second throughout. Gender Agenda right there now coming to tackle from third. On the inside, Wishing Gate is in with a shot to extreme outside. Queen of the Sand joins them. Queen of the Sand, big run, grandstand side. Homeward bound now, and Queen of the Sand has just sweeped right on by. Queen of the Sand goes on with a Gender Agenda in a little tight, shifts ground to the outside. But Queen of the Sand in full flight for the wire is going to win it impressively. Queen of the Sand and Mike Smith stride home 3.5. Gender Agenda again second. Close then for third, Kathleen Rose and Oscar Body.
Field of 12 in here, the Phillies and Mares on the turf, and Mike Smith. Very patient ride in here for Patty Gallagher. Well back early, comfortable winner in what looked to be on paper an extraordinarily competitive race. But Queen of the Sand wins by better than 2 lengths, returning $8.40 as second choice in the wagering. Gender Agenda with Kieran Fallon in the saddle finishes second. Kathleen Rose finishes third. The 5-2 favorite, Kitten's Point, with Aaron Grider in the saddle, finishes 8th in Friday's Catherine Crosby. And now time for the 3-year-olds to race a mile on the turf. This time, Colton Gelding's, one of my favorite movies of all time and a popular horse racing movie, Let It Ride.
And away they go to an even beginning. Final step out very fast from the outside gate, and Final Step sprinting away early will clear the field and go on to lead it. Forever Juanito, Homeschooler joins second. In behind that, number 5 and Papa Turf. My Baby's dropping down onto the rail, a good 6 lengths off the leaders. They're going real fast out front. I'll Wrap It Up is taken back third last. Then comes Cabral. Inside of Cabral is Awesome Return. Past the 3/4 pole they go, and Final Step's really taken a hold of the bit here. The rider's having a tough time controlling him, and he's just taken off now. Final Step sprints down the backstretch. He leads by 5. Homeschool second. On the far side, we have number 5. Then Forever Juanito. Up alongside of that is My Baby, and they followed by I'll Wrap It Up down at the rail. Alongside of that comes Awesome Return, getting closer. 3 back to Cabral, and Papa Turf has dropped out last. 3/8 of a mile to go now, and Final Step is slowing down up front. Final Step coming right back to the field now. Homeschool and number 5 come to take him on. Looks like they're going to go right on by. They sure are. On the outside, My Baby starts a run. Forever Juanito waits for room at the rail. Can Forever Juanito get through? And he has Awesome Return. White blinkers, grandstand side. Awesome Return's coming flying. Number 5 tries to keep him at bay now. But it's Awesome Return striking the front with 100 to go. And awesome return, impressive today. Awesome return, and Mike Smith win it just over a length. Number five and a flying Cabral. Cabral number five in a photo for second.
Awesome return, Mike Smith in the saddle. Almost a repeat from Friday afternoon. On Saturday afternoon, the offspring of Decarchi going out for Mike Pipey scores the pop, the 8-5 favorite victory by a length and a quarter. Awesome return. Returns $5.40. Not so awesome. I guess better than trashing your tickets. Number five finishes second. Cabral finishes third in the Let It Ride Stakes. And continuing with the Hollywood theme on Sunday afternoon at Del Mar, the Betty Grable Stakes.
They're all set. And away they go. Came out well in Tribal Gal, shifted in shortly after the start. Tribal Gal now goes on to lead them. Racing between them is Swiss Lake Yodeler, a close-up third, more complexity. Montpetit on the far side. Meinert Zagani is racing fifth, only four lengths off the leaders, been followed then by Sweet Marini. Kiona is in behind that. Warren's Veneta is back second last, and Sutton Sunday trails a good 10 lengths off the lead. Into the turn they go now, and Tribal Gal goes on to lead them. Swiss Lake Yodeler's racing along in the second position at the rail. Meinert Zagani. Montpetit's right there on the far side. More complexities in fifth. Sweet Marini is the grey. There goes Sweet Marini now making headway, and Sweet Marini goes all the way up to second, and now Sweet Marini's tackling the leader. We come back to more complexity. Kiona running on late Sutton Sunday. Top of the lane now, and Sweet Marini's made this big run, gets the lead and goes for home. Sweet Marini's the new leader. More complexity comes to tackle. Tribal Gal, Meinert Zagani's got room at the rail if she's good enough. They come for home. Sweet Marini's holding on. More complexity tackles Meinert Zagani. Warren's Veneta with a late run, extreme outside. More complexity, the leader. More complexity gonna win it. More complexity got up to win it. Close for second, Sweet Marini, and a fast closing Warren's Veneta. Then Meinert Zagani.
More complexity going out for Mario Gutierrez. Scores by a half a length, returning $9.20. Sweet Marini finishes second. Warren's Vendetta finishes third. Tribal Gal, the 5-2 favorite in Sunday's Betty Grable, beats one horse while finishing eighth. Turning our attention back east, Saturday afternoon, Phillies and Mares on the turf in the 12 furlong Long Island Handicap.
They're in the gate. And they're off. And the 12 Phillies and Mares head out for this 12 furlong Long Island Handicap. And Invading Humor is going for the early lead. Danza Cavallo, a little headstrong there in between horses. Aigu Marine is on the inside with Viva Raffaella. Then comes Giant Shadow, who's racing in fourth. Danza Cavallo still a bit to handle there in fifth. On the inside is Tabreed in sixth. Embar now moves up a spot. And then comes Maximova, followed by Hellenistic. Old Alliance has made her way down to the rail. Then comes Song of Ice and Fire. And the trailer is Mary Shika in 12th. The quarter went in 24 4/5 seconds. They come through the stretch here for the first time, and it's Invading Humor. And she's built a three-length lead over Viva Raffaella. Down on the inside is Aigu Marine in third, followed by Giant Shadow running in fourth. Danza Cavallo seems to have settled down now and is in fifth. Embar's on the outside in sixth. And then it's Tabreed down at the rail and racing in seventh. Maximova's in between horses in eighth. Old Alliance, Hellenistic on the outside. Then Song of Ice and Fire, and Mary Shika continues to trail. They move around the clubhouse turn, and it is Invading Humor with the lead here by 2.5 lengths. Viva Raffaella in second. Aigu Marine down on the inside in third. And Danza Cavallo is fourth. The half in 51 seconds. Three quarters in 118 over this yielding turf. And now they're midway up the backstretch for the final time. And it's Invading Humor still there by almost two. Viva Raffaella in second. Aigu Marine is third. Danza Cavallo is fourth. Four lengths from the front. Then it's Giant Shadow, Maximova, Tabreed, and Embar on the outside, followed by Old Alliance, Hellenistic, Song of Ice and Fire, and Mary Shika. into the far turn, Invading Humor. Viva Raffaella now begins to pick it up on the outside. Invading Humor, three quarters of a length. Viva Raffaella in second. Danza Cavallo is now gaining ground from third. Then it's Embar, Agumarine down at the rail. Maximova is now coming on. And Tabreed as the field comes down for the eighth pole. Danza Cavallo is the leader in Maximova. And on the inside, it's Agumarine. It is Danza Cavallo with the lead on the inside. Here comes Agumarine. Agumarine, Danza Cavallo. Agumarine got it right at the end. Ahead, separating the two after a mile and a half in the Long Island Handicap.
And one of the chagrins when we do the Long Island Handicap in New York under the modern era, we know that graded turf action in New York. The curtain is coming down, but the third time was the charm. Agumarine scores the victory. This offspring of Galileo, sent out by Christoph Clement, brilliantly ridden by Johnny V, returns $15.20 over the yielding turf course on Saturday afternoon. The 8-5 favorite, Danza Cavallo, finishes second. Maximova, almost 25-1, finishes third in this year's Long Island Handicap. Ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Enjoy your stakes action from around the country and join us next time on Horses and Courses.